Elena Limmer, Executive Director and Curator at the Wiregrass Museum of Art in Dothan, Alabama. Thank you so much for joining us this afternoon as we walk through the gallery, the exhibition Threads and Layers with Sara Garden Armstrong, who is here with us from Birmingham, Alabama today. Please join me in welcoming Sara Garden Armstrong.
This is so great to be here. It's also, for me, a very special show. Threads and Layers, Sara Garden Armstrong Threads and Layers, is curated by Paul Barrett, who really had to, he said, Sara, we got to put your older work and your new work together. And that's such a gift to get to think about, because we all, as artists, are always just into the moment of whatever work we're doing. And we forget to look back and be able to think of the connecting threads and layers. So I'm standing right in front of a piece of work, a part of the part that I did in 1978. And it had speakers in it. We don't have speaker sound with this piece now, but it's very modular. There are 16 forms. And it, I was dealing with sound, and actually the drawings over here are my studying and trying to think about how the sound, using the color and the forms themselves and the movement between. Also very much studying the shapes and how that trend, I was airbrushing, and very much the trends, the movement of that color. Something interesting. At this point, I'm teaching at the University of Alabama in Birmingham, and my studio is over in a upholstery shop on the second floor. And sometimes, so these pieces are a built structure of plywood, and then there was a pattern that I made and cut, and they are sewn and airbrushed. So there was a real relationship to the upholsterer that was downstairs. I also, with these drawings, I have a sewing machine in the studio, so some of the lines are sewn with that. And the sewn line is so different from the graphite line. So for me, it was, it was really fun. This is also some of the work that has never been shown before. And it feels great to have this work here and be able to show it to the public. So let's look up here for a second. This piece right here, or part of it, this is another early sound piece that I did before moving to New York. And the speakers, it was really a floor piece instead of a wall in spatial. But the sound was scored, the score for the sound was taken from the negative spaces and then projected on a sheet, which also told me when I would come in with the sound and how the sound would determine the duration of that sound. So always the forms have, in the sculpture, have for me been part of the system that scored whatever sound that I did. And so a little bit later we'll talk about some other later modular pieces or pieces. Let's go in here and look at these drawings. This is a series of drawings that I did in the late 90s, early 2001. And what they're about is about time and change of time. I'm spending a great deal of walking along the shoreline in Brittany and in Long Island. And with this work, I was obsessed with, I've always been sort of obsessed with water and how the ocean, how it comes up, and the sound system that it is, very close to breathing. It's very giving and it's very taking. But what these drawings were about, it was about the edge of the water. And it's really a term, a French term, littoral, and that's the title of this series, I was photographing that edge, and so it comes up and it never is again. So it's a great deal about change. And I, at that point, was projecting these lines on and very much using eraser, a great deal of sort of mark making, and they're landscapes. They are about change and time. And a lot of our work, I think, has been about landscape, whether it is exterior or interior. But and that's what this, they're very Asian looking at me because I'm not using any perspective. They're very flat on, you know, it's very flat. And I'm dealing much more with the surface because I was dealing with the surface of the water, the lines above that the water made or marked. And that was important for me to continue that sort of thought system about how time and change happen. So, in thinking about the water, let's look at some earlier work that dealt with water and the beach.
Instead of going just to the paper mill to get the sheets, I am now spraying with paper fiber, and this is in my studio. So, you know, once you get to have something in your studio, it opens up lots of doors about what you can do with that material.
This piece, reciprocating supports, was done in the mid early 90s. It actually is part painting in the early 90s, but it's this iteration of using these parts is formed a little bit later. At the time I did a show at the Bronx Museum in Public Space, and it was very much my mother was in the hospital. I was very much sort of very, the war, you know, things were pretty bad. And so this piece was a little bit about doctrine. And it's called Reciprocating Support. And it's about breath and about health. And it's about how important the breath is. And so it's, and living. So, you know, I think when we always look at things, it's about that combination of the living and the dying. But all of that is so important with that. But you can see with this.
Thank you. control, but not, and then understanding when something really does happen. In another piece that is current, a new piece but here, is landscape gardening. This sort of began at an exhibition at Basement 11, and this is the third or fourth generation. Now, I talked about modular. Modular for me is it's parts and they change with locations because you're dealing with the space that that work is being put in. And this is certainly one of those pieces. It grew out of my working with LEDs that was for a commission piece where I was working with a piece that was commissioned by a multiple sclerosis designer. But again, once you've got a material, you want to use it in many ways. And this piece about the sort of, for me, it has a relationship to people, and that all the LED light is white, but it all has been covering on the outside, so it's like our skins. We're all the same, but we do have these very different colors, and it's part of that sort of life cycle that. Continuing with breathing, this is Breathe a Box, and this piece over here, it began sort of covering up a radiator, and then because I've dealt with breathing so much, it became having the bags in there, the sandblasted plastic, and you know, and the change with lights. And it's, for me, this is very meditating a piece, and that you can just sit with and be. And sort of, again, like that water, like walking on the water's edge, where you go into that system of just, you know, the world's okay. You have this, the quiet sound system. I think the other piece over here is also a little bit about that meditation and with my work. You can see that these are interior, I mean, it's called Overture Series. And I'm spraying with the hoses and piping and with the individual pieces instead of being part of the installation. And, but it's interior instead of exterior, and you know where from what it is. You know, this is braided strand, like a little braided string, excuse me. But again, talking about materials, because I am so invested in the process and how that leads from one thing to another. The LED, I study and work with the LED, with the sentient matrix that's in UAP. The other material that I worked with, I had to get some material that was from a model that was very much like a blue gum. And so after a very long time, what I ended up with doing was gel medium, which is the medium that you use for painting with color pigment in it. I ended up layering it on the glass and putting fiber and being able to manipulate that. So that, again, I think it comes from the sort of what I was doing with the spray and pull, what I'm doing here is again that sort of weaving in, but a very, very different material. We'll look at some books. Maker, but I've done books, and I'm not a paper maker, but I've done paper. You know, so it's for me, it's always, you know, there's a point where you want to have, you want to go in that direction for some reason. When I did the piece that actually is right over there with the show at Duvernay, and I was dealing with interiors, and so I wanted a book that dealt with interiors. And so you can see here, I am layering, and I was spraying fiber so that you would not get, and then this goes into a plastic box that slips. So again, another interior. So it goes into that. And I'm not the best at doing additions, but I have, at least that has got more than one. And so this interior piece that really affected me tremendously. I spent over a year working on it. And I had done a series of air player installations. It began with just air moving out and blowing on you. I was in a group show at PS1, and I was going to have to compete with sound. I had never competed with sound. I didn't want to. I always had my spaces just for me. And so the idea I came up with, that sound was air. And so I ended up blowing sound through these sort of curved pipes out of the wall. And that series took on a life of its own. It ended up going to floors, so it was over a decade. And these were large installations, and I really wanted to translate those into a book. I was traveling a lot, I was going to Europe. I just wanted to be able to carry something. You couldn't take these installations. So I did the Air Players book. Now, it has two parts, and this is, I had to have sound in it, and I had to have light in it. And then with the limited edition, I very much wanted to have change. So let me just show you. This is the limited edition, and this is the little book that this went out on its own. And it also had to, the publisher said to me, you know, if I'm gonna work with you, you have to have light in it. And as that was extremely hard, and so you open the centerfold and the light is there, it has a lens and all this packaging. And so it really does talk about that whole series. So I've done another book. Well, let me keep on with that. Excuse me. Let me just show you that. So this is a video, and then this again, this goes in, and it closes up, and then this is the miniature environment. Since these pieces were, they were an environment, I had to understand how can I do something that is an environment. How, you know, that I spent a great deal of time up at the Museum of Natural History, looking and trying to think and understand. And so it has a back and a front. I also live next door to a sandblaster. I think I, you know, like most, a lot of projects that I do, I have a huge amount of unbelievably great people working with me. And, it even has a manual to let you know how to change the LEDs in it, how about the wiring and all of that. So, this was 1990. And so that, it really changed me in a certain way with this. Now, there is another book, and it's the book, Sara Garden Armstrong, Threads and Layers. And when this happened and I realized, I thought, you know, you've done a hard project like that before, but this time it's very different because it's a book. You can't add all those materials. But one of the fun things I want to show you about this is when I was trying very hard to come up with a cover, you know, what is the cover going to be? You know, thank heavens I have a lot of friends that can say, oh, that's okay. And when someone says, that's okay, you mean that's just like the kiss of it, you know, yeah, it's not okay. And so eventually, somehow or another, I came up with the change of light with one of these images. And with the book. And so you can see that it is, that this cover is very much from this piece. And the glowing it up, because for me it had mystery, it related to what my work was, but you don't know where it is. And that's what I wanted. I wanted something that just said, this is interesting. I also wanted it sort of pretty, and so that it would, you might want to pick it up to see what's in it. One great thing, we're going to have a book signing this afternoon, and it's going at the museum from 4:30 to 6. We all have our masks, and we hope to see some of you all. It would just be great. And just to, so you can see what the book looks like.